You're listening to Rock, Pop, and Roll. It's Rock, Pop, and Roll. I'm Rob, live to digital in Indiana. Podcast, thanks for coming along for the ride. Take away my solitude. So I thought of, I thought, can I do this? Can I make it do this series? I want to do a series, and it's called Play Me Five. Can I play just five songs from an artist's catalog, from all the albums, from all the singles, the live albums? Five songs that do two things, that give a representation of the artist, the musician, the band, the singer. And as importantly, take the moments or the moments in the songs that reveal a bit of the magic of that song and the performance and the musician. The idea, that's the soul of this podcast episode. Can we hear a band or a performer and in five songs find the reason, a bit of the understanding why they are who they are and why they matter in the continuum of rock and roll? That's it. Let's go. Rock, Pop, and Roll, Play Me Five. We're going to start with Bob Seger. Why Seger matters, or how he matters. Why does this Bob Seger, man, and up front, I love Bob Seger more. I respect Bob Seger, man, is one of my favorites, and I'm a Springsteen fan, and Tom Petty, maybe the best rock and roll, I mean, you could argue, but of all the rock and roll era, it's an argument, right? But through the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, until he died, Tom Petty, love Springsteen, Mellencamp, CCR, all that stuff. But I go back to Bob Seger a lot for, I don't know if it's the simplicity, I don't know if it's for the nostalgia. He's essentially like a journeyman rock and roll singer from Ann Arbor, Michigan, and by extension, Detroit. But he's got a place in rock and roll history, and he's in the Hall of Fame. And every time I hear Bob Seger, I turn it up. We'll play five Seger songs, and it's going to be the overview, and we're going to tell some stories, and we're going to give you a little bit of... I discovered some stuff doing research. You got to know that Bob Seger had this popularity imbalance in the mid-70s. A great example of that was in June of 1976. He was the headliner at the enormous Pontiac Silverdome just outside of Detroit. About 80,000 fans showed up for Bob Seger, 76. This is a couple of months after he had released the Live Bullet album. 80,000. Drove to Chicago, did Seger the next night. Played for, some people say 1,000, some people say a few hundred. So Seger was this iconic, even then in Michigan, rock and roller. But they released Live Bullet in April of 1976. It was recorded over two nights at Cobo Arena in Detroit, the legendary Cobo Arena, recorded in September of 75. Nutbush City Limits is on there. Turn the Page is on there. Heavy Music, Ramblin' Gamblin' Man. Music critic Dave Marsh wrote that Live Bullet is one of the best live albums ever made. And particularly, he says, during the medley of Traveling Man and Beautiful Loser on side one. Open for everybody. I mean, Kiss, Aerosmith, we could Google the list. So that's where Seger was. Here's the five songs that, and you probably know Seger because you're listening to the podcast, but as an exercise of, does this work? And do these songs truly represent it, the man, the music? And it's going to be up for discussion and your disagreement, and you'll have different songs than my five, but that's the way we're going to play the game. And the first song I'd play for somebody is Night Moves. How could you not play Night Moves first? It's like no-brainer.
I was a little too tall, could have used a few pounds. Tight pants, points, hollering out.
And this may be one of my three favorite, five favorite songs of all time. Rock and roll, of all time.
Points all her own.
Said way up high. It took him 6 months to write Night Moves. He recorded it in Toronto, Canada, had a producer by the name of Jack Richardson. Seger had taken the Silver Bullet Band to Toronto, 3-day recording session. This was the third day. They had gone home at this point. So what he did, Seger had the only remaining members of the Silver Bullet Band that were still in Toronto with him, bassist Chris Campbell, drummer Charlie Allen Martin. Seger played acoustic. He played piano. They got a couple of local session musicians, three background singers, Sharon Lee Williams, Rhonda Silver, and Laurel Ward. They sing. It's not the regular Seger backup singers that you hear on the classic stuff. It's these Toronto girls. And that was how it was recorded. Odd, right? Released as a single in December 76, it went to number 4 on the Hot 100. His first hit single since Ramblin' Gamblin' Man. He said he was inspired by Kris Kristofferson's Me and Bobby McGee to write it. The descriptive imagery of that song. He said he also saw the 1973 film American Graffiti. Seger says it came out at the theater. He's thinking, I got a story to tell too about where I grew up. Summertime in Michigan. Seger said he was also inspired by Springsteen's Jungle Land, which came out on the Born to Run album. He said Jungle Land had a double bridge, two bridges in one song, so he put two bridges in Night Moves. And maybe the greatest part of the song is it works on two levels. Night Moves, the moves you're making in the back seat, and also the way life moves and Night Moves. Clap of thunder. Unable to fall back asleep. So Seger twists the phrase. Instead of action, it's about the
last night to the sound of thunder.
Passage of time.
How far off I sat and wondered. Started humming a song from 1962. In a funny how the night moves. When you just don't seem to have as much to lose. Strange how the night moves. With autumn closing in.
The great breakdowns. Bridges of all time. And then the acoustic comes back. Night Moves. There you go. I don't know that you can argue that one, right? You can. I mean, I don't know that you can. Play me five, man. There's one. One from Bob Seger. I'm Rob. This is the Rock, Pop, and Roll Podcast. As we're playing five songs from Bob Seger that embody, that represent, that you would play for somebody maybe who's never heard Bob Seger, whoever that might be. Song number 2, it's unclear where and when this was written and when and what it was written about. I read that it was something that happened in Dubuque, Iowa, something that happened in South Dakota. Seger said it happened at a truck stop in Wisconsin. It was written in 72. And this song, according to David Teagarden, who was touring with Seger at the time, later in the Silver Bullet Band, he said they were driving from Detroit to South Dakota, blinding snowstorm, 3 a.m. They needed to get gas. They went to a truck stop. Seger and the band stuffed their hair up in their hats. When they walked in, a row of truckers started saying stuff. Is that a girl or is that a man?
This is from 72 also. About being on the road. It's called Turn the Page. Yeah.
1, 2, 3, and...
It became Turn the Page. The iconic Alto Reed sax opening.
On a long and lonesome highway east of Omaha, you can listen to the engine moaning out his one note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before.
True story, says Seger. Absolutely true story. He said, I was thinking about how people hate you because of the way you look and how unreasonable it is. But the bigger thing, he said, was the weariness of the road. And he tried to capture that for all the people who travel a lot and just plain miss their home or their family or both.
See, here I am. On the road again.
The road manager for Seger said, Tom Weschler was his name. He said he told Alto Reed about the intro and the sax playing. He said, Alto, think about it like this. You're in New York City. It's in the Bowery. It's 3 a.m. You're under a street lamp and there's light mist coming down. You're all by yourself. Alto, show me what that sounds like. And so Alto Reed played the melody that opened and closed. It's just in two spots, opened and closed. Turn the page. I think I just got goosebumps just listening to that in my headphones. Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band, we are playing Play Me Five, the third song on our Play Me Five game. It's the medley. It's the fantastic, unbelievably great smashing together of two songs seamlessly. It's Traveling Man and Beautiful Loser from the Live Bullet album.
Up with the sun, gone with the wind. She always said I was lazy.
It's like 8.5 minutes of live Seger with the band. Just perfect. Just a perfect medley. It rocks and it's introspective. And it's off of that fantastic Live Bullet album.
Women have come, women have gone.
I mean, the crowd, it's at Cobo Arena, it's 10,000. Cobo Hall doesn't exist anymore. I think it's like a convention space now. They got rid of the arena. But it was Seger in front of a hometown crowd. And they're quiet as he's doing this. Just like entranced through the quiet parts of the song. And Seger does what Seger does, man. He and the Silver Bullet Band just build the thing, and it grows, and it gets ready to get louder, and then it explodes, and that's what the magic is, the moment.
Wealthy soul.
I went with my great friend Brad Schaus. Brad and I, we've gone to a lot of shows. We've seen a lot of people. We've seen Bob Seger a couple of times. I remember we were supposed to see Bob Seger. I remember we were sitting in a bar waiting for the show. We were, you know, pre-gaming at a bar, having a couple of cocktails and getting ready to go across the street. I mean, we were downtown, go across the street to the show. And I don't remember how we heard, but we heard there was like a text or we saw an email or because this was mid-2000s. Show's canceled. We ended up going to that when it was rescheduled, and we went. The last time we saw him was I'd have to look up the year, but it was like 2017, the last Seger tour, whenever the last Seger tour was. He played the Outdoor Shed outside of Indianapolis. We call it Deer Creek. It's got a corporate name, but we all call it Deer Creek. 24,000 people. His drummer is Don Brewer, who is the drummer for Grand Funk Railroad. So Grand Funk opened up. We hung in the parking lot in the grass field where you can park for free. It's unbelievable. Built into the ticket price. That's cool. And hung out there, and they went into the Seger show, and it was packed. And it was when he came on, it was a great show. And that was the last time he was around. And he was like, you know, whatever age he was, 70 something. He did Traveling Man and A Beautiful Loser. And it was just as magical in a different way that night. And then Brad and I, we went to a little town called Rushville, Indiana, that had, during the summer, you know, all the towns now, the thing to do is you've got some kind of stage. You bring in a band, a tribute band, most of the time. Anyway, we went to Rushville and they had a Bob Seger tribute band. And they did Traveling Man and A Beautiful Loser. And it was when they did it, I got goosebumps that night with a tribute band doing it. Because they, when they change from one song into the other, it gets me every time. Right there with the keyboard. I think I got goosebumps again. I did. I felt that one. Hey, this is Rock, Pop, and Roll. If you want to find all the episodes of the podcast, you can go to rockpopandroll.com. We've got everything there. We've built ourselves a digital warehouse. Spared no expense. It's there for you. So go find the old episodes, the older episodes. Go find all of them. It's all there. Anyway, we've done like 40-some of them. Play Me Five is what we're doing today. Five songs from, and that one I'm counting as one song. That is Traveling Man and A Beautiful Loser off Live Bullet. I know it's two on the CD. I know it's two on the album. I know, but it's one. It's one when it was on the radio. I know it's two, but it's one. So we are up. We are up to number four. So at number four, we jump into the night. So those were all older songs. And this one's still, it's old too. It's 1980, but it's off of the Against the Wind album. By this time, Bob Seger had become, he was a star, superstar in the rock world arenas. You know, they weren't playing stadiums so much at that point, but he could sell out any arena he wanted to. And the fourth song that we are going to dig into is one when I remember hearing this in 1980, and I thought, that's not quite the Bob Seger. That's not the Chuck Berry guitar riff Bob Seger that we might have been expecting. It was the first single. They planned to record this for the 1975 album Beautiful Loser, but they didn't. So it was released on Against the Wind. This single went to number six on the Hot 100. It was a hit. It was played a lot. And as I look back on it now, as I listen to it now, I love Fire Lake. I love the harmonies. I love the lope that it has. I like the story.
Who's gonna make that first mistake? Who wants to wear gypsy leather?
I mean, what's going on out at Fire Lake? That's what I thought as I was listening always. Where's Fire Lake and where? How do I get there?
Who wants to break the news?
Or maybe I don't want to go there because there was a melancholy to it. It's like, it seems like there's something not right at Fire Lake, too. Fire Lake. And who's singing background vocals? Clint Fry, Don Henley, and Timothy B. Schmidt of the Eagles. And the moment of the song that is the hook is this right here. Fire Lake's our number four song, and it's a little different, and it's the Muscle Shoals rhythm section plays on it. Barry Beckett, Pete Carr, David Hood, Roger Hawkins, the Swampers, Jimmy Johnson on guitar. and the Eagles cooing in the background. And I don't know that anybody was hotter than the Eagles either in 1980. Because Bob Seger was friends with Glenn Frey in Detroit when Glenn was just a kid, like teenager. Seger was a little bit older. Glenn Frey sings Ramblin' Gamblin' Man backup vocals. It's so pronounced on, if you'll listen to Ramblin' Gamblin' Man, when the background singers come in for the first time, Glenn Frey comes in so hard that you hear them actually, manually turn down the volume of the background singers because Glenn had come in so hot. There you go. There's your story. It's Rock, Pop, and Roll, Rob, with you for the podcast. Tell your friends. Tell your neighbors. Thank you for listening and subscribing, if that's what you do. And the number five song, the fifth song out of our five on Play Me Five, is a live song because, Seger Live is really what it's about. Trying to Live My Life Without You was written by a guy named Eugene Frank Williams, popularized by Otis Clay, kind of, 1973, sort of popularized, went to 102 on the charts. So not really a hit. He did play it. I found that he played it on Soul Train. Seger recorded his version of the song on his Nine Tonight album, which was his second live album. Did Live Bullet in 76, and then when he was big, double album, double LP of Seger Live. Trying to Live My Life Without You. And it's an unassuming, great little live thing that it puts you there. Feel like Seger talking to you.
Feel funky tonight? Oh yeah. Ooh. Oh yeah. It's an old Memphis song. Old Memphis song.
Just a great single. Horns and stabbing keyboard. And it feels so live. And he's on top of the world. And we love this. And this was played on the radio a lot.
Breaking those habits was hard to do, but never compared to the changes that you put me through.
Trying to live my life without you, man.
And when I saw Seger when he was later, maybe even that last tour, but that 2017 tour that Brad and I went to in Indianapolis, I remember he played Trying to Live My Life Without You. Looseness and funky. And a soul shouter. That's Bob Seger. That's Bob Seger. And that's our five. That's our five Bob Seger songs. Play Me Five. If I played those for somebody who didn't know Bob Seger, I mean, he's got a catalog, right? He's got Roll Me Away, which Dave Marsh, the writer, says is his best single. Hollywood Nights. Rock and Roll Never Forgets. You'll Accompany Me. Fire Down Below. Ramblin' Gamblin' Man. Heavy Music. Sunspot Baby. Main Street. The Saxophone of Main Street. He's got all those. So, I mean, there's a lot you could choose from, but those are the five because of that Seger. And it's the live shows. It's the soul. It's the crunch. Some of the Chuck Berry. I mean, Night Moves was Bob Seger's album that transitioned from like a raw Seger to a polished Seger, I think. That was the transition album he had back in 72, Smokin' OPs, Mongrel, the songwriter albums, the Bob Seger System, Bob Seger and the Last Herd, some of his bands. But he had that Chuck Berry. He was the line from Berry and Little Richard and 50s rock, with a place in the 60s next to Mitch Ryder in Given Detroit, a garage, a rock and roll sound that could ultimately be refined. He got bigger. He got better. He became one of the kings of the Midwest, of Heartland Rock and Roll. guitar rock, drums, some soul shouting. Seger refined it.
Took a look down a westbound road, right away I made my choice.
He was alongside Springsteen and Petty and the REOs and the Cheap Tricks, came after the Mellencamps. They had a roadmap to where they could go, where they might want to go, a roadmap to how they might be able to get there themselves. The Ramblin' Gamblin' Man. I mean, I love that single too. Can't choose them all. Hey, if you like the show, you can email us, rockpopandrollpodcast@gmail.com. Thanks for listening. Share it on the social media pages, that you might have. Go to rockpopandroll.com to find all those episodes. Find the contact information. We've got that there, too, if you didn't remember to write it down or remember it as we said it. Just go there. We're on Apple Podcasts. We're on Spotify. We're on iHeart Podcasts. We're on all of those places. So wherever you get your podcast or you want to tell somebody about us, go find it where you find your podcast. I do that all the time, and people are no problem. They can do that. Hey, one last fact. Time for one last fact. Because we do this every time. Live Bullet is a staple of still classic rock radio. But back in the 70s, it was a staple of FM rock radio. Not just in Detroit, but in Michigan. The live version of Nutbush City Limits, the medley that we played for you of Traveling Man, Beautiful Loser. That was on all the Detroit stations, W4, which was WWWW, one of the rock stations, WABX, WRIF, which is still around in some form. And now WCSX is the classic rock station that keeps them alive. But back in the 70s and into the 80s in Michigan, I listened to it. I was living in Michigan. I was a teenager growing up in my musical formative years. Let It Rock, Turn the Page. A song like Get Out of Denver was a song that was played, all the time on those rock stations. And I don't think it was played in other cities. I don't think. Get Out of Denver. I heard it in my town in Michigan. So the one last fact that I have is on Live Bullet, there's an announcer, an iconic announcer at that Cobo show. Dan Carlisle is his name. He was a W4 DJ. Dan Carlisle is iconic because of his place on this album and what he said and how he tried to keep the crowd rocking. Dan Carlisle. He's just fantastic. Dan Carlisle. I found him. You can hear him. He's now on on KXF. And try that again, Rob. He is now on KXSF, which is a San Francisco community radio station. And he does a show. He does a show every Monday, noon till 2 p.m. his time. Dan Carlisle was the man. That's our one last fact. The only number one hit that Bob Seger had was the song Shakedown. Did you know that? Soundtrack of Beverly Hills Cop 2. Glenn Frey was going to sing it, but Frey lost his voice before the session started. Seger took his place, rewrote some verses, kept the chorus. No matter what you think you pull, you'll find it's not enough. And it's his only number one. Out of all those songs, this was the pop, the pinnacle in terms of getting to the top of the charts. But hey, he made it. And he brought his Segerness to it. So, gosh, give it to him for that. That's the only number one for Seger. He had 7 top 10 hits. Night Moves was number 4. Shame on the Moon was number 2 from The Distance in 1982. Still the Same went to number 3. Trying to Live My Life Without You all went all the way to number 5. Play that for you. Against the Wind was number 5. And Fire Lake. Fire Lake was number 6. So he had some hits, top 10 hits. But his only number one right there. Here you go. Thanks for listening. Thanks for listening. I'm Rob. Tune in the next time we do our thing. Looking pretty good today. Next time we play me 5. Is that 5? Is that good enough for you? Is that a game? What's your list? Send it to me. I don't profess to be right. I just profess to feel like if you played those 5 and the person was like, I don't know. We might not be able to be friends. That's all I'm saying. But what's your 5? There you go. To get us out of here. Oh, I love this one off of Against the Wind. It's shining brightly. Take care. Be good to each other. And as always, turn it up just a little bit louder. Let me hear you say. Shine bright. Let me hear you sing. Shine bright. Let me hear you sing. Yeah. Shine bright. Shine bright. Shine bright. Shine through the night. All through the daylight. Shine bright. Let's shine bright. Let's shine bright.
You're listening to Rock, Pop, and Roll.
Thank you! Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band, thank you! Good night! Good night!
Subscribe to Rock, Pop, and Roll wherever you get your podcast and find all the episodes at rockpopandroll.com.